Social media is everywhere, and so are those online profile pictures that we're all guilty of posting. Do you know that your profile picture can actually be hurting your job or your dating search? With us now to tell us how that is Ann Pierce, the co-founder and the CEO of PhotoFeeler. Welcome. How are you?
I'm great. How are you?
I'm wonderful. It's amazing that employers do a lot of their searching for employees, and for prospects online, and we don't realize what our photos are doing. So I want to tell everybody, we're just not going to do selfies anymore. Well, we can, but not when it comes to looking for a job or even for that dating, finding that special partner. Why is that, Anne?
Yeah, you know what? Our photos can feel so mundane to us because, you know, we've been used to putting photos on Facebook for years now. And a lot of us have a photo, maybe we put it on Facebook and it got a bunch of likes. And so we want to use that same photo on a professional network like LinkedIn. And you can't do that. You have to be really careful about what kind of impression you're trying to make and making sure that your photo is making that impression.
And you're doing some incredible things with photos and with actually having people evaluate the photos and so that we're really looking our best. So tell us a little bit about what PhotoFeeler does.
Sure. So PhotoFeeler.com is a free online service. You can upload your photos and find out exactly what impression they're making. So if you look trustworthy or fun or confident. We do have, we have users. It's a really supportive community. So it's sort of a give and get system. So you give feedback on other people's photos. We'll ask you, does this person look trustworthy? And you say, no, somewhat, yes, very. And you can leave notes as well. And we're really, really careful about making sure that it's a very supportive community. There's nothing snarky going on our site. So it's a great place.
It's supportive and it's also confidential. And you really get to know how other people, not just you, but how other people are viewing you. And what are some of the mistakes that people make when they're putting up a professional photo? Or what they think is a professional photo?
Three really, really common ones that I see all the time. The first one is clothing. So like I said, maybe you have a picture that's a really, really flattering picture of you and you want to use it, but it's not right for LinkedIn. You really need to be wearing something like you would wear to a job interview on LinkedIn because you want to for people to view you in that way, in that professional way. The second thing is a distracting background. Maybe you took a picture on the beach on vacation or in your living room. And again, it's a great photo of you. It's very flattering, but you don't want a recruiter, a potential employer to be envisioning you on the beach on vacation, to be thinking about you in your living room. A professional photo should be all about the person. It should just be you, neutral background, blurry background. Your eye should not be drawn to the background at all.
You know, you and I were talking about lighting, and I was telling you about some person, and we're not mentioning names, whose her eyes looked so creepy, and you said that it probably had to do with lighting. How does lighting affect us both socially and professionally?
Yes, absolutely. Lighting is so big. Lighting really sets the tone of a picture. So it's, with the wrong lighting, you can come across as sinister, as creepy.
Right.
Sometimes people have like half of their face shaded and it comes off as shady. and it can make you look unflattering. It can draw the eye to the wrong places again. And there's a lot that could go wrong with lighting. So it's really important.
I would like to tell people who are interested in attracting that special person, what do they need to do to really portray, like you said earlier, someone who's trustworthy or kind? Or what happens that they need to do to make sure that's what they're projecting to other people?
Sure. Above all, I'd say smile. Smile with your mouth open, if possible.
Why? Why with
Because
your mouth open?
a smile with your mouth closed, it can come across as you're holding something back, whereas a smile with your mouth open, it's the way that you naturally smile when you're happy. And so it comes across as open. You look like a fun person. Really, it improves everything. It makes you look more trustworthy. It makes you look more confident. Cannot go wrong with a smile.
So, what are some of the other things that people do wrong in putting up their photos?
Again, the selfie is big.
Forget it. No.
So it's so easy to do, right? It's so convenient and it's private. You're in your bedroom and you can take a couple different photos. But it really, the main thing is that it causes facial distortion. So
Wow.
it throws your proportions out a little bit. You actually look different than you really do. So maybe your chin is closest to the camera. It's larger than it is in real life. It just kind of distorts your face. And so it's going to be much more flattering, and it makes you and it's much more true to life. When you take a photo, either you put it on a stand and you step back a little bit with a timer or with a remote for your smartphone, or you get someone else to take the picture. So that's a
Great. Thank
huge
you
one.
so much. And remember, it's so important for us to look trustworthy and genuine and put out the picture that we need. Thanks again. Up
Thanks for
next,
having
we're
me.
heating things up with a Latin dance party that's sure to get your blood pumping and your body sweating. You don't want to miss the party when we come right back, and you don't want to miss me having a go at it.